But I did warn him 2 years ago that vulnerable people using his website could end up dead. Now I've got a call girl who is using the site to find clients. She's facing manslaughter charges. Brandon, of course, right with me here tonight via Skype. Brandon, what have you instituted as this vetting process you said you were going to institute?
Well, first of all, Dr. Drew, you're calling her a hooker. You're saying that she's using it to find clients. I think that she's alleged to be doing so. Until she's proven guilty, we don't know if that's true. Because on the website, her profile is completely clean. And when we looked at her activity on the website, she wasn't soliciting. And if she was doing so, she was suddenly taking that activity off our website, doing it off the site.
That's not exactly a ringing endorsement of how you can vet people who are sort of inclined to these activities. But Anahita, do you have a concern?
Actually, I think it's fine to just call it glorified prostitution. I don't know why you don't just admit that. And I don't have a problem with it, Dr. Drew, because if he doesn't have this website, someone else will develop something like this. In fact, there are plenty of these websites. I think it's about individual responsibility. You can meet someone in a bar and go out with him, and he could be a murderer or a rapist. So, you know, more power to you. If people are that desperate and they feel the only way they can get a girl is to flaunt their money, and if girls are that desperate that they want to go become hookers and go on this website, more power to them. But I don't think the onus should be on him.
Let me point out again, she is being accused in court, charged with prostitution. But my concern is, you guys, and Sam, I'll let you comment about this, is that it's like to me, it's not different. Now, you guys can argue with me about this, but it's not different than a drug dealer providing drugs to addicts. This is people providing an environment to trauma survivors to reenact their traumatic histories.
Exactly, and that's what I'm concerned about, and actually a question that I have for Brandon is that, to me, any real confident, mentally healthy young woman is not going to want to exchange sex for money or go out on dates for money.
By the way, confidence is not, self-confidence is not a good parameter of detecting who is troublesome in the way they would use a site like this. But go ahead if you could answer Sam's question.
How are you screening these women to make sure that they are mentally healthy and they are not past trauma survivors?
Well, first of all, it's impossible to screen anyone for that. I'm not a psychologist, and certainly a website cannot do the job of a psychologist, number one. Number two, I think there's a misconception of what seeking arrangement on any of these sugar daddy websites is. It's not a prostitution website. It's a website where women can find wealthy men who are going to spoil and pamper them. What's wrong with that? What is wrong with having a wealthy boyfriend who will buy you gifts, take you out, spoil you, pamper you? Every girl wants to meet and marry a rich husband. That's just the nature of our society.
Anahita, you got to get in there. See, it's not a prostitution ring. It's for you.
It's for girls like me that want a rich husband, right, Dr. Drew? I mean, I agree with Brandon. I don't think there's anything wrong with this website. I think it's about individual responsibility.
All right, counsel.